I was like, Johannes, no way, come on. We need to finish this project. We have a tough timeline behind it.
Hi, my name is Johannes. I am a software developer at Marco Polo and I've been working here for 4 years.
Hi, my name is Sidonie. I'm working for Marco Polo since 3.5 years now. The first 3 years I was working as content manager and then I was working as business development manager.
Hi, my name is Maria. I am a technical project manager at Marco Polo and I work for the company for over 10 years now. We start, as usual, in a software development team with a daily, so 15 minutes for everybody, talking about what we've done yesterday and what we are going to do today.
And then we're doing a quick monitoring check of all our systems. And finally, we can start coding, which also introduces code reviews and having a very close exchange to other developers.
And of course, we also release kind of once a day so that we enable our developers to bring the solutions that they are building faster to our client. Within the past 12 months, we did a shop relaunch, a classical one, so front and then back end. We moved from a monolithic system to a distributed own developed software solution.
So basically we had a code freeze on the old shop, or we just did the necessary maintenance. And every developer was just working with this new process.
In the past, we didn't really have any content management system at all. So every page had to be put together by scratch and we didn't have any preview. So we built modules kind of blind and we always had to deal with this difficult maintenance.
All the developers are kind of struggling and are kind of afraid to touch it, because if you touch it, you didn't know, does it break on another place or not? So whenever we needed to do a bit more complex feature, sometimes we just gave up and kind of put everything as a HTML code into a text box. That is horrible in terms of maintenance, in terms of migration. So yeah, nobody liked it. Nobody was happy with that.
We were looking to introduce a content management system in order to enable the business departments to work nicely with the system and also to enable our software developers to build good software that they enjoy also working with. Within the first month of the project, what we did is to build a feature list and get all the requirements from the business departments. When you introduce a new software, it's always like, what do you want to have? Feel free to give us all your requirements. But then from week to week, we noticed that we cannot fulfill these requirements. And this is kind of not satisfying when you start with a new software. When you go freshly into a new project, you're all highly motivated and you're kind of stopped by or limited by your surroundings.
So nobody was really happy with it. And I was then thinking to myself that there must be something out there. And then I did a little research and I found Storyblock.
Johannes was approaching me and like, Maria, I want to try out a new CMS solution. And I was like, Johannes, no way, come on. We need to finish this project. We have a tough timeline behind it. And now you want to try out something new. Okay, like you have 2 days. If you convince me after these 2 days, we can go with it.
Fortunately, there is a free version, so I could start right away to build a prototype. 2 days later, everything was set up and running smoothly.
The first impression that we had seeing the prototype Johannes built for us was really fascinating, because we couldn't believe that in only 2 days there was a finished product and it really looks like the solution we wanted to have.
So I was convinced, then we convinced also the other departments and our project leads, and then we restarted the CMS project within this bigger project and it was a success.
So we then started to build the content with Storyblock, but then we realized you can do also much more with it. So we started to put our redirect handling into Storyblock. We started to put our shop configurations into Storyblock. We started to put our promotion logic into Storyblock. And first people were kind of asking, is it a good idea to have such things into a CMS? And nowadays people are saying or questioning, can we do that with Storyblock? For example, for us it was very important to show different content modules to a different customer group. And I mean, there is no out-of-the-box feature in Storyblock that provides that, but it's so flexible that you can easily build that on your own and you can structure it on your own. So also that was a check.
At this point, we could imagine what great progress we would achieve with Storyblock. And it is really easy to build content with Storyblock, so we can change and rework content in a really easy way. And especially the visual editor makes it really easy to build content for us, and we build the content twice as fast as before.
So in our current system, Storyblock is way more than just a CMS to us. We are coming from this huge monolithical system where every function and every integration is within one system, and currently we also have functions in the content management system, which is not typical for a CMS. But for us, it's the best way to have it there, to have it easily maintainable for the developers and easily accessible for the content management team. And this is kind of the best solution and setup for us.
So I can recommend everyone try it out. You will start to love it. You are in charge of what you want to build. You kind of own it. It's not your software, but it feels like. And it was pretty cool to see that a new software got introduced by developers instead of the business departments.